Hey guys, Sam here from BeFit Physiotherapy. Today I just wanted to quickly touch on a shoulder warm-up series that you can use to help get yourself prepped for either some shoulder rehab, some back rehab, or if you're just doing a generalized upper body strength conditioning session. I'm gonna show you some ideas that you can use to incorporate into your warm-up for your shoulders and your back, and we're gonna use a variety of tools that we have in front of us, so band, broomstick, long band, plates, and also our own body weight. Now remember, the reason why we warm up is for a couple of reasons. One, we want to ensure that our training performance is at its best. The better we train, the better adaptation we get, the better improvements we get, and the better performance we have. Following on from that, preparing the muscles, the tissues, the tendons, and the nervous system correctly can ensure that while we do train, and especially when we're trying to push ourselves to the limit, we do so in a way that's effective and efficient and minimizes the risks of any injury as well. So that's enough about the theory. Let's get into the practical. So the first thing you want to do with any kind of warm up is make sure your heart rate's elevated and that you're sort of moving blood flow throughout your body. So outside of this video, you should start your warm up either on a bike, on a treadmill, on a ski erg or a roller erg, anything that is mostly full body that will get your heart rate elevated. If you don't have access to any of this, a light walk, a light run, or just some body weight movements in the gym will be fine as a substitute. Now let's go over some ideas that you can use for a general shoulder warm up. So the first one we're going to use is the stick, and the stick can be used for a mobility routine. So the very simple one is what we call stick raises or dislocations. Basically, you're going to stand up, lift the stick up as far as you can, and then come back down nice and gently. And the great thing about this exercise is it's really nice and simple. There's lots of variation you can do with it. So you can do a narrow grip, or you can do a wider grip. You can also go pronated like I'm doing, or you can do supinated. And you can also add some rotational component into it. So you can swing around, you can go back with one, back with the other. You can also do more extension-based work. Really, it's endless limitations in terms of what you can do, but it's a really nice way to just mobilize the shoulders, and you can, you know, spend anywhere between 10 to 20 reps or, you know, up to a minute doing this, and that will be adequate enough to get your shoulder mobilized. Following that, we might want to start priming the key muscle areas that are going to support the shoulder and the back. So we're looking at rotator cuffs, we're looking at deltoids, we're looking at rhomboids, traps, and any other muscles that sort of support either the scapular region or the glenohumeral region or the shoulder region. So with a mini band, for example, something that you could use is just a basic isometric hold, or an isometric hold with some movement. So for example, we might want to put the band around our wrists, elbows tucked in, and just do an isometric external rotation, just like this. Then from there, we can just hold that position for time, and you should feel the tension working through your shoulders. We can also move while we're doing isometric holds. So we might want to keep the tension on the band while also moving into some shoulder flexion, or we can work on protraction and retraction as we do it. So there's a nice little combo that you can do there. Outside of the mini band, you might also want to use a long loop band to work on some either shoulder or back work. So for example, a banded pull apart is a great example. Hold the band up to chest level, pull the band into your chest and squeeze your shoulders. You can see my arms stay mostly straight here, and I'm really just trying to work on squeezing my shoulder blades back when the band hits my chest. You can also use it as a general primer for your shoulders. So you might want to do some upright rows, for example. You might want to do some bicep curling. You might want to do some single arm raises. It doesn't really matter. Just adjust the band tension accordingly and make sure that you're working through movements that prime your shoulders and your back. Finally, you might want to use some light resistance to start getting the muscles, the tissues, the tendons, and the nervous system ready for heavier loads. So, for example, we might have some weight plates and we might do some front and lateral raising as a way to prime the shoulders. So we might go up into a front raise, hold, come down, up into a Y raise, hold, come down, and up into a T raise, hold and come down. We might repeat this a couple of times, get those shoulders going. We might also want to use the plates and do a bent over YTW, which is more for your back. So we're going to hinge at the hips, bend our knees. We're going to go into a Y, squeeze our shoulder blades, into a T, squeeze our shoulder blades, and into a W and squeeze our shoulder blades. And again, similar to the YTW, the front YT raises, same thing with the YTW bent over squeezes, we're just changing the position and still working through our back. Now, once you've done a couple of these, you might start progressing into your key lifts. And again, you'll just start by gently increasing the load. So you might start with just a barbell if you're doing barbell-based work, or if you're doing dumbbell and kettlebell-based work, just start lighter, but focus on the movement pattern that you're doing for your key lift. And then from there, you get into your main working sets and start working through. So I hope this has provided you with a couple of ideas of how to get your shoulders and your back warmed up. They play a very strong relationship between each other. So whenever you're doing some upper pushing or pulling work in the gym or for some rehab, it's great to incorporate these kind of exercises into your warm-up to make sure you're primed